Hey you guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you've been here before, if you haven't, my name is Josephine O'Sherie. I go by Calmly Bunchy on my YouTube channel here, and today I'm going to be giving you guys my barracks room tour. I'm currently stationed in Liz, Texas, and I just wanted to do this real quick before I go to sleep because I have to work tomorrow. So yeah,
I'm gonna start from the front door. This is our front door entrance. The hallway's on the outside of that door. I just don't want to open it right now. So as you come in, you come into the kitchen. Two rooms are right here. We have a little seating area right here, and that's the bathroom. So I'm gonna work my way this way. This is the bathroom. I have a mirror right here. That's me. Two compartments. This is my roommate's, but it's a compartment. You wanna see that opens. This is my compartment. It's basically my side of the sink, her side of the sink.
Basic bathroom. We bought the shower head from Ross. It was like $20. And then each side has little shelf areas, which I kind of really like that. And then the curtain rod is like curved, like the hotel style. What's here? We got here a little hook thing you can use to hang your clothes up to dry. I thought it was so cute, but yeah. The toilet, everything, yeah. Here, female stuff.
We're back in the kitchen. A lot of shelf space, top and bottom. So we don't have a regular oven. We have a conventional oven, but it works, you guys. It works. I made cornbread in here before. Nope. Just basic run through of the shelves real quick. Because people be curious, child. We use every bit of this space. And no, me and my roommate don't have like separate sections of stuff. For the most part, we don't. The bottom of the cabinet wasn't in here when we got here, so we still use it anyway. Utensils, plastic, storage stuff, more stuff, seasoning drawer, more food goes under here, empty. I just cooked, you know, prepped for a week because I start working tomorrow. Back on the floor, dang it. Refrigerator, pretty basic, nothing going on too much. And it's like a rectangle table. You see the lines right here on both sides, and you can flatten it to make it smaller so you can see more of your space. This is my room. It's pretty big, it's pretty large in here. Hold on. I want y'all to see, like, my curtains, where the window is really high compared to like the space for the floor. But starting over here, I put two hooks behind the door to hang my stuff. Simple trash can. It's actually really cute, but I turned it around because $3 at Walmart. I know y'all probably seen this at Walmart, and it's a trash can. So I keep my boots, uniform boots here, because this is where my scent is at, and just in case, you know, it's, I don't want the rest of my room to smell like stale from boots and stuff. These two art pieces I got from Burlington. It came both in the same pack for like $25.99 or something like that. This I got from Walmart, $3. I painted it gold myself around it. It was silver, I think, yeah. This little shelf thing came from Burlington as well, and it was $20 for this little gold shelf you're looking at. Funny story is, this was not my original desk that was in my room. I had the older desk that has like the shelves that come with it, but my roommate wanted it so bad because she likes the lamp and stuff, so we switched out desks and stuff like that. So, but I'm glad we did, because it made my room, it just took my room to another level, just to be able to like add my own shelving and do what I want to do with the whole desk area space. Yeah, that's it for the most part. I have like, this is my basket for like, I put my keys in here. Oh, I just throw receipts and stuff. And you can't be like grabbing when I come out the door. I do. So my keys stay here and my pouch, because this pouch goes everywhere I go. This is a journal somebody got for me. I haven't used it yet. I feel really bad because it was kind of expensive. Anyways, brought my journals, planner, books that I haven't read, Bible, I've read it. More books. This is my like savings envelope thing. I use it sometimes. Sometimes I don't. It depends. This is my to-do list for the week. I kind of have to update that tonight because I have a busy week ahead of me. My calendar is October. Oh, this lamp. It's actually a diffuser. I don't fill it up often. Comes up. You fill it up with water. I usually fill it up really high. Essential oils are in here. My room sprays are in here. And I just put like drops of that in there and let it go. Or I usually just use it for a nightlight. So this light, I'm always using it because I like the mood light of it. And I didn't want to get an actual like big bulb that takes over the whole room and it's like too much mood light. Because I feel like too much of a good thing is bad. That's just my concept. Here's to my favorite corner of the room. I needed a body mirror, so I got a body mirror. Oh my God, it's dirty, you guys. Just ignore it. The mirror, I painted it myself. Why did I do that? I painted the mirror myself when I got it. I don't know if y'all could tell. Okay. I sponge painted it with silver and gold paint. I did the same thing also with a little bit of the lining of my calendar because it was silver. I also like did that too on the calendar and stuff. But I did the whole thing around it because I wasn't with it. It had like a bronzy feel to it. If I could find the picture, I'll show you. This mirror from Ross, it was $50. It is very light. Like, it looks big and grand, but look, it is very light, you guys. Very, very light. These reading lamps, that's what they actually are, but I turned them into LED lights because I didn't want to do like the whole nine yard of like all around the mirror. I was like, this is convenient because I got them off of Amazon and they go like this. You turn them up, down, side to side, switch it around so you can get more light on you, more light away from you. You get the point. And then it also changes tones. So put them together were like $20 something. Plant, the stool, the plant is from Burlington. The stool is from Burlington. The stool is $10. The plant is $15, I believe. I'm not sure right now. The curtain is $3.75 each and they were from Target. The command hooks were from Target as well. I'm not quite ready to go over here because there's a lot going on over here. But just to show you what I have in my drawers real quick, just don't talk about it. Y'all be curious. They're not as organized as they used to be. It's just a matter of like, yeah. Bookshelf, I got it from Target.com. I think it was $30. I got the shelf specifically for that projector right there. Mm-hmm. It's near the show right now. Center of the show. That was the main thing in my room. Like, okay, I didn't care everything else in my room. I was like, I got this projector. I need it to sit comfortably where I can adjust it to where I need it to be, blah, blah, blah. So I got the shelf. Shelf really like took my room from basic to just wow, you know? And I really, really love it. So we'll start from top to bottom. Top part, that little circular thing, Five Below. It came by itself. The little two pieces in there was also from Five Below, but it came off of this plant right here. I cut them off of that plant and I put it in there. Yeah, I don't know, I just did it. This little piece came from Burlington. I just picked it up because it was gold. These books, I read a little bit of one of them, but not that many. These prayer cards came from the dollar store and it just so happened, I didn't buy them to actually put them up here. I really actually low-key wanted prayer cards. I was like, oh, okay. I saw it in the line, I was at the dollar store, picked it up. And then after like I bought the greenery for my shelf, I realized, oh my God, this goes. This is a Juicy Couture perfume that is actually smells really, really good. But I just put it up here for like decoration. A lot of my scents are up here for decoration purposes too, as well. Why go out and buy decoration when you can just put things places that you actually use. Second shelf, really old, and I just kept it because, ooh, you still smell it when you open the thing. And plus, I think it's because it's near the projector and it's on. I don't remember, but I just kept it because the gold white, the projector, I got it from Walmart. It's a really nice projector. It doesn't have like Netflix or anything on it, which is fine with me because I don't have Netflix. This is it with lights on in my room. Like in the daytime, you can watch whatever you want to watch and it shows perfectly fine. This is just a video for YouTube, so like with the black, and you can see everything pretty well. And you can also adjust, you can adjust the brightness on here. Brightness is set to 74, like 70 or something, and you can adjust it. I don't know if y'all can see it moving right there in the corner.
Turn off some of these lights so y'all can see it better.
And then you press back. That's how it looks. So this projector is actually a lot bigger from this distance, but you can resize it, and that's what I did using the settings to fit perfectly in between here, so it just looks like a big flash screen TV type of thing. Okay, these I got it from Ross probably last year sometime. See the price tag still on it? Somebody bought it for me and I had three of them. Oh, I still have three of them. I said I had, well, I still have three. I brought them with me, so, and it just happened to go. Second shelf, this came from Burlington as well. I really liked it because it went kind of with that a little bit, kind of, let's say it, you know, a little bit. These scents, I just put them there because they look cute to me. This candle, I put it here because it looks cute to me. It smells really good too, but I haven't burned it. Can't burn candles in the barracks, you guys. These fragrances, I put them there because they have gold in it, duh. This is just here because I legit use it and I just bought it and it smells really good. Second shelf, same thing. Just very resourceful and very useful. I put things on here that I can use. I didn't want to like go too crazy with decorations. Bottom shelf, and this is one thing I feel like changing for the most part. I got these two little pieces from Ross and I feel like they're pointless. They do go with all my decorations and stuff. But at the same time, I feel like they're really, really, really low-key pointless. And then this basket came as a set with the other two right there. And so I just, you know, found somewhere to put it. Over here into this little corner, we'll start up high. So if you watch my vlogs, I think I literally, the day I made this shelf, I kind of recorded myself painting it and stuff. I didn't record myself like going it up. Story behind the shelf. See how sturdy it is. It's pretty sturdy and I did a great job putting it together. If you go on my last room tour video from when I was in Fort Sam Houston, these are actually two books, like book holders for a bookshelf, like to make it a bookshelf to hold your books up. And I just glued it in the center like that. It's like the, you know, the clear glue got really messy and looked really disgusting. I took some leftover paint that I had from painting the painting that's behind me, I'm gonna talk about in a minute. And then I painted, I just like painted over it with the paper towel, literally a whole paper towel. This is a speaker I bought from Walmart about over a year and a half ago, probably. This is from Amazon and this is the reason I wanted my shelf, so like I can put my phone up here and like, let's say if I'm talking to somebody and I'm in the bed, it's gonna be eye level and I don't have to like lean over, because I was gonna buy a whole like bed, like a nightstand that's taller, and I was just like, that makes no sense, but whatever. Pretty much just that. Oh, and the way I reinforced it, you know, the hooks that come with the curtain rods, I used those, super glued it. I was gonna nail it in, but it was not working out for me, so I had to like super glue it with super glue, and I used some command strips and I really like tightened it underneath there, so there's like there's no space in between this and that, like that's the only space and it's not going nowhere, y'all. I'm so happy that I thought about that before even buying a shelf. Down here to this lamp, I bought this lamp from Amazon. She's really cute, she goes with my aesthetic, so I was really happy for her. I like the wood. It goes with the wood for the rest of the room. Like funny, the good thing about this lamp that everybody really loves is like it's a very tap lamp and you can like change the temperature and stuff. Kind of like my reading lamps over there. So cold, really warm, semi-warm, and then you can adjust it to make it brighter or make it darker. I don't know if y'all can see what's happening. To make it darker, make it lighter, and yeah. I use this to connect it to the projector. I literally made a hole behind like the little sheet back of the shelves and perfectly aligned to where I want it to be according to the shelf spacing or whatever, and made a hole through there. So this is connected. This is the HDMI that just stays in there, and then this is the actual wire for the projector. I plug it into the wall, hook this. This is like an adapter you can use for your laptop and stuff, and it has a lot of sockets and stuff, and it was a pretty good buy, very beneficial. Hook it up in here, and boom, I washed off. I watch movies and stuff off my laptop or just YouTube. I watch a lot of YouTube and stuff. All right, to my bed. Y'all probably already seen my bed before. My beddings, I haven't changed them yet because there's no urgency to change anything when it comes to my bedding. I think I might just change it because it's like, it's getting old and stuff, and I've had this like comforter set for a minute, but it's doing the job. With those, there's two black pillows back there and two black silk pillowcases. Those together were almost $50. Just not for the week. Oh, this is a new addition to my bed though. This is like a pillow headboard. I think it's from like dorms.com. Dorms stuff. I don't know. It's called Dorm something on Amazon. And basically, like, it's not nailed. Well, I kind of tacked it to the walls. But I'm just holding it up by like literally strands right here. And then you tie it to your bed stuff right there. And that's how that works. It's just my drawer where I keep a bunch of like feminine products, skincare stuff, all my little organic chapsticks, my spoolies, all my little knickknacks, stuff just in here reach that I need sometimes when I'm, that's a major, just a bunch of stuff. Makeup bag, I don't know what's back there, let's not even find out. So under here, I have like these baskets that I got from Dollar Tree. They were $3 a piece because Dollar Tree now is no longer a dollar, it's $1.25, and they also have more than a dollar section. See, the tag is on here, $3. I bought them because I needed the more store space, and I just got them different colors, but they look cute and whatever, and I placed them under the bed. I also got these two bins I really wanted to take back, but I was just like, you know, keep it. And that's where I put like all my like electronic stuff in here. And what's in here? Oh, this is all like extra braiding hair. So I guess it did come in handy. It's like all a bunch of braiding hair. I think I have a wig in there. Drawers. And this is a new addition to my room. I got it for $30. She's looking a little janky right now because I've been stepping all over it, but it's very like beautiful. I don't know if y'all can tell on camera, but like she has like shimmer in it. I don't know if you can tell, but you know, it's not too big, so that's why I liked it. And it's just like the perfect size. If like I need to take it out the way, I can take it out the way and put it back down. We could talk about this because the reason it took me so long to post this video, like to do this recording video, is because I really wanted to like decorate over here. I don't know if I still will. I think I might because I know me. But at the same time, I'm like, okay, it's not that deep. It's these little sticks for me. Okay, we can start here. So this is my wax warmer basket I got from Walmart. I just put them under here so I don't do my best. This place does get cluttered. If you watch my vlogs, you probably see like this is where I put a lot of my packages, and like sometimes when I come in from work or whatever, I put stuff there. But I just keep most of my stuff out of eyes view, but looking good, sit up somewhat. I just got these organizing bins from Walmart. Oh, this is the original box for the projector. My hair tools, I would say, was bent. So I have like flat iron in here, I have my blow dryers in here, my the heat up cap I use is in here, all like my hair combs, hair brushes, they're all in there. Or I used to have a drawer
If you look on my page, my last room tour, I had like a whole first aid drawer. Now I have like a bin because it wasn't feasible for me.
Back to this corner of my room. If you see peeking up from behind the bed, all my like suitcases and everything is behind, like it's under this bed. I had to like really think a little harder about how I wanted to do this, but it worked out because all I did was just push the drawers out, and now I use that as a stepping stool to get up into my bed. I'm tall, but like sometimes I need that extra so I don't mess up my hips anymore. And yeah, that's that. The mirror back here that came in the room, it was pretty unsturdy. I usually keep this door open for the most part. First, because I like how my closet looks. You would keep the door open too. Like, I mean, it's not the best closet, like don't get me wrong, but I just like how aesthetically pleasing it is for the most part. And yeah, so we're gonna go inside my closet. On the top, I just got, oh, this is where the other bin is that's underneath my entertainment center over here. This bin, I just keep like feminine products in here, like my pads and stuff like that. And my honey pot wipes, they all go in there. This, I call this my travel hygiene pouch, whatever. My towels go in here. My fitted sheets and like pillowcases and extra stuff. Also in here too, they're in the front. These are just sweatpants that I'm gonna wear again, but they're not clean enough to go back over here, and they're not dirty enough to go in a dirty clothes. This too, this is my pants I'm gonna wear to the gym whenever I go again. This is my hair care, my hair product stuff. Hold on, let me take. So this is my hair care stuff, like all my hair care products. I literally just like threw away a bunch of stuff that I know for sure that girl's not gonna be using. So yeah, you have pretty much everything a girl needs, a natural girl may need for her hair in here. These are products I just bought. I have to do a review on it. And yeah, stacked up on these. I got half of them free, but it's not the point. The point is, I got them. That's what the point really is. This is just skincare stuff and extra like body sprays that I don't currently use right now. At the moment, I just keep them in here. Shea butter, yeah, hair care, skincare stuff. Up here are just bags, totes, purses. Most of them I don't really use like that. That's the computer bag. I got it off of Amazon. It's really cute, but it's really big. It's huge. Dang, we can come back over here. This right here, if you go to your local Dollar Tree, you can find this, and it's pretty sturdy. Like, y'all, I got a lot of clothes on here, and she holds on for dear life, and I've had this since Fort Sam Houston. So I just took my roommate to a Dollar Tree to go get one because they really do have them there, y'all. If y'all need some, go get some. We start here. I just have like t-shirts that, you know, outing t-shirts that are still pretty decent looking. These are all my tights, shorts. These are compression shorts that I got in the men's section. So they're pretty much compression underwear for men, but I like them, so I bought them for myself. These are swimsuits, bralettes, kind of like lingerie type of thing, but not really, more so like bralettes and laced garments, but mostly bathing suits type of stuff are in there. This little drawer thing, I got it from Walmart. It was $9 for that, and I was just like, oh, that's cute, it can fit there. These are my shorts. This is probably my sweatpants section, but I don't have that many sweatpants. And yeah, these are all my jeans, and they're not many. I'm wearing some right now, so that's that for the most part. Dresses over here are jumpsuits, skirts and pants. I don't have many skirts, I don't know, that's not my theme. A couple like casual wear dress shirts. And then I just hung this up before I start this video. Back here, that's my dress uniform. She really stays in that bag because from the moment I got issued that dress uniform, it's been hell on earth and it's been costing me too much money to get everything altered. OCPs are back here. My jackets, sweater, denim jackets. Only have about three. I'm gonna get some more because, oh, this is, I thrifted her too. And yeah, she is thrifted. Isn't she cute? Anyways, sweaters, like kind of sweat top, long sleeve tops. They're kind of like sweater material, thick material. My windbreakers, and then literally 90% of all these dress shirts that I'm holding are thrifted, you guys. It's probably like one or two I actually bought. So I bought this one from Amazon because I had like a New Year's outfit I was gonna wear in 2021. Never wore it. This one though, she's thrifted. Do you see the vintage? Like, you can see the vintage just coming off of this. She's definitely thrifted, but she's definitely hot. So this is definitely a summer thigh-high boots type of look to her. Anyways, shirts, I wear these in the summertime when I don't want clothes to touch my body because it's too hot. That's my go-to look. Long sleeve shirts. These are most of my crop tops and like body suits and stuff. These hangers came from Ross. Yeah, down here I have this little basket that I keep my extra, my hair oil that I don't have to go up there to get when I need to oil my scalp every 2 days. Some skin oils, just other things that I really don't feel like putting back where they're supposed to be. Usually when I come out the shower, I come directly in here. So I moisturize myself over here with this mixed deodorant, boom. My towel usually goes right here. Undergarment drawer, not together. Undergarments. See, like, it's very usable friendly. I saw my last room tour, which you should go check out. Like, just see the evolution of the room tours. They are cheap, they're battery operated. Oh, I didn't tell you, so the lights over here, they're not battery operated. They actually have a charging station and they turn into a desk lamp. When I'm in here, it charges. What I do is usually my laptop is sitting here, or I'm actually using the desk. Plug it into your laptop, boom, now you have a desk lamp. This is the selling point of my room. Like, I knew this wall looks very basic. I know it does, but it still gives very much minimalistic vibes. And that's why I kind of, there was an itch in me to be like, oh, get like two matching, you know, quotes or something and go on the side, blah, blah, blah. But I was like, no. I like what I see, so I'm gonna keep it. The original plan was to do was to get like the peel and stick wallpaper for this whole entire wall. Well, this wall and this wall, and I was gonna stop like right here, but I didn't. So yeah, that's how that went. My phone is about to die, so I had to plug it in. Literally, I'm recording this from the charger. Did it myself. I can insert clips of the proof. It's pretty easy. Look at my little signature. Yes, by the artiste. It was very much the plan. Like, this was okay, yeah. As good as it's gonna get. I'm trying this for the first time. Well, I've kind of done paint pouring before in the past, but nothing ever this big. And I liked what I see, and I'm glad that I kept it. Here, this was like, the swoops were like unintentional. And then I added more of the neon colors, like the orange, and then I splashed colors on top of it. And I was like, oh, it's kind of cute. This is what people buy for like lots and lots of money. I'm gonna keep it and I'm gonna put it above my bed. So there's no story to that. I didn't even sign it because it's technically not my artwork alone, and that would be kind of trifling to do that. This is my pride and joy, the reason I can sleep at night. I'm kidding. But I really like this painting. I'm proud of myself of how I did this painting. And I don't know, I wanna like record stuff like this in the future, but I don't know if people would be interested in seeing stuff like that. All right, you guys, that was my room tour. I hope you like what you saw. For the most part, I know I think it was giving. Hold on. If you did, comment below, like the video, do whatever, like subscribe to the channel, do what you gotta do to just show me love and show that you appreciate my viewpoints of designing and like aesthetic eye. Like, just tell me something, talk to me, just support me, you guys. Okay, that's all I want to say. Thank you so much for watching this video once again, and I'll see y'all in the next one, which is probably gonna be like a vlog because I vlogged before I made this video, which I'm probably gonna close out the vlog now. Okay, so bye.